Scenes of devastation and desperation. Misery that seems to have no end in sight. Nearly 3 weeks after the floods ravaged one-fifth of Pakistan, people are struggling to cope with one of the worst natural disasters in living memory. As the waters continue to rise, they look on helplessly at nature's unending fury and the destruction it has left behind. Aid has been arriving in the country, but it's slow and simply not enough. While visiting flood-affected Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, UNICEF's regional director for South Asia, Dan Toll, said the scale and scope of the emergency has not been understood by the international community.
We need rapid, huge support. There are millions of people displaced. What I've seen in the last 24 hours is people who have lost everything. If you look in this camp, if you look inside a tent, there is almost nothing inside the tent because people have lost everything they've owned.
Many of the millions displaced by the crippling floods are now living in makeshift camps. UNICEF has been working with the provincial government to provide food and shelter to those affected. The organization has been delivering safe drinking water every day for a million people, along with critical medical supplies.
Our homes were destroyed in the floods. The ceilings cracked and the walls collapsed. We didn't have any place to sleep or a roof over our heads. We spent 17 days in the camp and then we came here. We got these papers to move here. Now we have no problem. There's water and we have bathrooms.
UNICEF is also supporting mobile medical teams, vaccination campaigns and sanitation services in the region.
UNICEF is here in Pakistan and has been here. We will stay here. So UNICEF will support Pakistan through this emergency. UNICEF needs support of others. We need support of the international community. We need the support of our donors to be able to help the Pakistani people. We have released $7 million from our internal reserve to be able to act quickly, to provide the water you see in this camp, to provide the sanitation you see here and elsewhere. That has to continue, and this is a very small scale. We have an emergency with maybe 20 million people affected.
For Pakistan, the road to recovery will be a long one. The magnitude of the tragedy is still unraveling as each hour passes by. Millions of people have to rebuild their homes and their lives. Millions who've lost everything but hope.